Minister Keir Starmer has called for a general election. I just want to get your reaction to what's just happened here. Yet another Prime Minister, Tory Prime Minister, has stepped down. Your reaction?
Well, I'm not somebody who's easily surprised or easily shocked, but I'm surprised and shocked that just a few weeks after Liz Truss became the Conservative leader and the British Prime Minister, we have the chaos we've seen over the last few days and weeks leading to her resigning today. Keir Starmer is absolutely right. What we don't want is yet another internal Conservative leadership contest with another Conservative leader becoming the UK Prime Minister. More continuity, austerity policies. What we need is for Liz Truss or whoever Conservative members choose to be the next leader to give the British public the opportunity of voting for a fresh start. And if a general election was called, I'd be campaigning incredibly hard for the British public to vote for Keir Starmer and the Labour Party, because we have some of the responses to the big challenges our country faces. And I'll tell you this, Christian, I'm here in Buenos Aires with some of the leading mayors from cities across the globe. Think of any major city across the globe. The mayors or leaders are here, and we are a laughingstock. Our reputation is being diminished every minute Liz Truss has stayed in office. And people here this morning have been asking me, what is going on in your country? On the one hand, you know, you're showing global leadership for London, but on the other hand, your country is a laughingstock. And there are mayors here from the global south who say, listen, we used to look upon the UK as providing certainty and calm. You have the mother of all parliaments. We look to you for moral leadership, and we are a laughingstock.
You know, you said it before I was going to ask you. I was obviously going to ask you about that, because one of the things that really did stand in Britain's favour for so many, you know, decades and centuries was its very powerful position on the global stage. So what do you think, and particularly you're there at a World Mayors Conference, about the environment and how best to push through climate change laws to save, basically, humanity and the planet. And I just want to ask you, because you know that the crisis happened in Parliament last night over a fracking bill. And this Liz Truss-led government and her ministers have been very unfriendly to the idea of climate regulation and climate policy.
So, what we know is Liz Truss was selected and chosen by a very small number of British people, Conservative members. And we also know that her campaign was supported by donors who have vested interest in fossil fuels, whether it's fracking, whether it's petrol, whether it's gas. So it's not surprising. When she became Prime Minister, she was espousing policies incredibly unpopular with the British public, incredibly damaging to the environment, but very convenient for her supporters. And what you saw yesterday wasn't simply a rejection of her views to accelerate fracking, which could cause earthquakes in our city, but also the disunity in the Conservative Party. Look, climate change is happening. We saw this summer in London temperatures in excess of 40 degrees Celsius. We've seen in China the hottest summer since records began. We're seeing flash flooding across the globe. In Pakistan, we saw flooding leading to 33 million people being displaced. We've got a choice, which is to kick the can down the road, to set targets for 2050 or 2065, or to turn this crisis into an opportunity. It was another Prime Minister, a Conservative Prime Minister, but a far, 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 far better one than the one that's resigned today, Winston Churchill, who said, never waste a crisis. And what you have in Buenos Aires is mayors and leaders from across the globe. Today, we've announced we'll be creating, with businesses, 50 million green good jobs by 2030. And tomorrow, we'll be announcing policies where we give billions of pounds of support to the global south, who are least responsible for causing the crisis we have now with climate change, but suffer the worst consequences. And we've got to give them support in relation to loss and damage, but also to address these issues.
And you know, you said, and correctly, that it's a huge issue for the British public and publics all around the world. the climate issue. And as we've said, your leader plus the Scottish First Minister plus the leader of the Liberal Democrats have all called for a general election, and no more internal party selections that are increasingly being called an undemocratic way to govern at this particular time. But what if you imagine there was a general election? What would a Labour government do? You've got a billions and billions of dollar hole in the national budget because of all of this. You do have external factors like the inflation, like the Ukraine war that's jacked up the energy and cost of living prices. Is this something that a Labour government would welcome the opportunity to be in power at this particular time?
Well, those of you viewers watching from outside the UK may not realise we have a parliamentary democracy. So it is possible between general elections for the incumbent party to change its leader and not need to call a general election. Famously, of course, we know Harold Wilson, Jim Callaghan, Margaret Thatcher to John Major, Tony Blair to Gordon Brown, Theresa May to Boris Johnson. But never have we had two leaders changing in between general elections. That's why it's so important in relation to the next Conservative leader to call a general election, because our constitution has never had experienced successive changes of leaders without a general election. The second point to make is, what do people want? Businesses, families, the markets. They want certainty, they want calm, and they want leadership which have a clear plan. And the Labour Party, with Keir Starmer as the leader, Rachel Reeves as the shadow chancellor, showed at the Labour Party conference, our convention, how we can have a combination of policies that give both economic competence but also social justice. And actually, what this government needs is to, you know, because they look tired, they've run out of steam, they've run out of energy, they've run out of road, is to make way for a general election, to give the British public a chance of a fresh start. And, you know, what Keir and Rachel have done with the shadow cabinet is, firstly, transform the Labour Party. So we've shown we're a different party to the one that got the worst results since the 1930s in 2019. Secondly, we've exposed the limitations of this government by being an effective opposition party. But thirdly, and as importantly, we've set out a positive vision for our country to have a green future, creating well-paid jobs going forward, British energy for British people in relation to sustainable energy, to make sure we create good, well-paid jobs, living wage jobs going forward, to build more homes, genuinely affordable homes that are energy efficient, that save energy bills, that address the cost of living crisis. By working with the private sector to create wealth and prosperity, the Labour Party is now ready to be the next government. And that's why it's incredibly important for the British public to be given the chance to vote for that.
And very finally, about the region where you find yourself right now, you know, very close by in Brazil, you've got an election campaign, and it's now much more close between Bolsonaro and Lula da Silva than it was thought. Bolsonaro has a record of really being anti-climate change legislation and actions, not to mention the possibility of questioning an election that he might lose, despite the polls closing, as I said. What are your fellow mayors saying about democracy and environment in, you know, in Latin America, and particularly Brazil?
Well, over the last 10 years across the globe, we have seen the rise of nativist populist movements. So right-wing, extreme right-wing politicians playing on people's fears, winning elections from Poland to Hungary, from America to Brazil. But what we've seen in the recent past is progressive politicians, by addressing people's fears, winning again from Australia to USA, France, Macron holding back the far right. We saw what happened in relation to other parts of the world as well. And I'm hoping this Saturday that the Brazilian people, you know, choose a progressive future, not somebody who, you know, is deforesting more of Brazil, not somebody who plays on people's fears in relation to the other, not somebody who appeared to be a COVID denier and is not addressing some of the big challenges we face. Many people I speak here, whether it's mayors, whether it's business people, whether it's you know, Latin American leaders, understand the challenges people face. I've been hearing stories about hyperinflation and real concerns about the future. I'm hoping, though, as a progressive, I know it's unwise to get involved in other people's politics, but I'm hoping, obviously, Lula wins.
Mm-hmm. Sadiq Khan, Mayor of London, thank you for joining us from Buenos Aires.